Preseason, Lesson 1, The Godwin Theory. When I look back on all of my accomplishments, one thing stands out. I broke a scoring record at every level I competed. At my high school, I hold the single season scoring record, 1998, and at the University of North Florida, I was the all-time leading scorer in 2002, in which I broke that scoring record in 2.5 years. Though people always ask me the key to my success, I never really shared it until I wrote this book. Every basketball player wants to be the big man on campus and score a lot of points. Let's face it, from the off-court praise to the media attention and respect, how could you blame them? Social media is now valid and relevant. Every player wants their just due. I too faced this dilemma, and being the systematic person that I am, I decided to do something about it. Like any task or goal that you make for yourself in life, when it's time to plan and mark objectives, you have to break things down into smaller segments. Let's look at high school basketball. Most high school games are 4 8-minute quarters. Right away, you see that the entire game is 32 minutes long. My approach to the game was very simple. I would say to myself, if I score 4 points in 8 minutes, I will end up with 16 points. If I add a free throw in there and score 5 points a quarter, I end up with 20 points a game and no doubt become the big man on campus. Right away, my confidence went to the next level as I said to myself, who can't score 5 points in 8 minutes? This simple theory was the breakthrough I was looking for. When you force yourself to think in quarters, it makes the game look easy. Out of all the ways there are to score the basketball, put back rebound, jump shot, layup, free throw, I realized that scoring was more about finding points than having the best jump shot. There was a big difference between a jump shooter and a scorer, and I wanted to be the latter. This mindset took my game to a whole new level. In high school, my goal was to score at least 6 points a quarter. Once I figured out the importance of rebounding, shot selection, and getting to the foul line, subjects that we'll go over later in this book, I started to put up huge numbers. The confirmation of my theory occurred when I scored 38 points the second game of my senior year. Three-pointers, layups, foul shots, and offensive rebounds ensured that I gave myself the opportunity to score every time down four. A lot of basketball players shut down when they don't score the way they think they should. How many players do you know rely on one aspect of their game to fill the stat sheet? If their jump shot is not on that day, or people don't get them the ball in the right position, their confidence and game are at a loss. In my senior year at Abraham Clark High School in Roselle, New Jersey, I averaged 25 points a game, garnering both a Central Jersey scoring title and a Division I scholarship offer to the University of Buffalo. When I got to college, the same rules applied, except instead of four quarters, I now had two halves. My goal every game was to score at least 10 or more before halftime. If I ended the first half with 12 points, I knew I had to score at least 8 points in the second half to reach my goal of 20. If I only had 4 points at halftime, then I knew I had to be more aggressive at the start of the second half. People always would ask me how I was able to put up big numbers consistently. There were nights in which I would end up with 25 points scored with only 9 to 12 field goal attempts. The secret was always in my theory. Most basketball players focus on one thing, making all their shots. If they start off 0 for 4, then their whole game is off because they have the wrong mindset. If I started off a game 0 for 4, then you better believe I would find my way to the free throw line or crash the boards for a cheap putback rebound. My shot didn't have any effect on the number of points I scored. What I was looking for was 5 points a quarter or 10 points a half. If I was counting pennies at the free throw line or scoring points in transition, I didn't discriminate on how the points came. The newspaper usually said Godwin goes for 28. It didn't matter how I did it. Below is a chart that breaks down the Godwin theory. In high school, you have 4 quarters, 8 minutes a quarter. 2 points a quarter, 8 points a game. 3 points a quarter, 12 points a game. 4 points a quarter, 16 points a game. 5 points a quarter, 20 points a game. 6 points a quarter, 24 points a game. College, you have two halves, 20 minutes each half. 5 points a half, 10 points per game. 6 points a half, 12 points per game. 8 points per half, 16 points per game. 10 points per half, 20 points a game. 12 points per half, 24 points per game. And obviously the NBA is the same as high school. You just have more minutes, which is 12 each quarter. Coach Godwin review for lesson one. Number one, you have to break down the game into quarters and halves. Number two, set a reasonable goal to score a certain amount of points per quarter. Obviously, if you're not a starter and you're coming off the bench, you know how many minutes that you usually get a game. So you just have to set a reasonable goal. You know, if it's 4 points a quarter, because you know you don't get as much time, then hey, that's 16 points a game. Don't rely on one aspect of your game to score points. I see so many players that just want to work out and they watch NBA highlights on Instagram or YouTube, and they think the game is in a microwave, that you're just going to go out there, come around the screen, hit every shot. It's not going to happen. Don't rely on one part of your game to score points. Incorporate everything from free throw line to rebounding, transition points. Just find the points, which we'll go over in a later chapter. Focus on scoring points and not just getting shots. The scoring mindset versus the getting shot mindset. When you're a scorer, you're going to find a way to score points. If you're just a great jump shooter, your game is predicated on people finding you, and that's not what you want. The game has changed, and not every point guard is a pure point guard. Some guys like to get the ball up themselves, so make sure you have a scoring mindset. Learn how to score with your mind and just not your feet. Make sure that you're studying the game of basketball, studying other players. When you get on that court, you got to size up your defender. You have to be able to see, you know, what is his advantage? Does he have long arms? Is he taller than you? Is he faster than you? Is he quicker than you? These are the things that scorers think. They score with their mind, not just their feet.